Hello, welcome to the Woolwinder podcast. Come and have a look at some of my winter wardrobe. Welcome to the Woolwinder podcast. My name is Francis, and if you haven't joined me before, welcome. If you're coming back, welcome back. It's so nice to see you. So today we're doing a slightly different episode, and we're looking at things, or I'm bringing up things that are in my hand-knit wardrobe, and I thought I'd share those with you. I was wearing one of my hand-knits, keeping me warm, while sitting outside having a drink one evening, and it just got me thinking about how much I enjoy wearing my hand knits, and I thought I'd get out some of those that I knit, that I wear regularly, those that sit in my wardrobe at the moment, and share those with you. So they are all Rowan knits. That's because at the time when I was in recent times, I was working at a Rowan store, and so they were the patterns that we were seeing all the time and were inspired to knit. Although there are now more other independent designers in my wardrobe, these all come from then. So I'll go through the patterns. I will talk to you about, whether I enjoyed it, whether I wear it, all that sort of thing. And just one point to note, because they are Rowan patterns, they are all knitted in pieces, so from the bottom up, although Rowan do some top down in the round designs, these are all knitted bottom up in pieces, and all need to be sewn up, and I don't find that daunting anymore. There maybe was a time when I was, and I know many people do, but I would say if you're one of those, but you really want to take on something that's knitted in pieces, it's worth doing it. I do find now that I'm knitting both in the round and in the piece construction, that the shoulders are much more stable on a pieced item, that you just get it, and it's easier also to tailor it and fit it. So there's definitely advantages to both. And if you are thinking about giving it another go, when you're sewing up, the two things that I think make a big difference to me is mattress stitch and lots of practice. So certainly from once I learned mattress stitch, it gives such a good result. It's really very easy to master, and it gives such a good result. That makes a massive difference. And then practicing things like picking up your stitches and so forth, and being willing, if it doesn't look right, to take it back and redo and restart it, all make a big difference. Okay, well, let's dive in and have a look at this first item that I am wearing, which is Helvellyn by Lisa Richardson. And this comes from a book called Rowan British Made, and it's knitted in Rowan Valley Tweed. And Valley Tweed is a British yarn, hence the magazine British Made. It's a lovely cardigan to wear. Let me show you. This is the design on the cuff, and then you have design going round the bottom. And I particularly like this kind. I like a bit of colour work, but I quite enjoy, I suppose, in the same way where you're just doing a yoke of colour work, it's really enjoyable to get stuck into a little bit of colour work and then go in and finish it off more quickly with the stocking stitch, and, you know, requiring less concentration, which is always, I always like to have something straightforward like that to do. So this was a great knit from that point of view. In terms of wearing it, I do wear this a lot, actually. I think it's something that I can throw on a more plain dress. It's definitely something I would wear with a dress rather than with trousers, but I wear it over a dress, and it brightens an outfit up. So it's also, I suppose, also it feels very easy to wear. So it's not too thick, it's not heavy. It almost feels a little bit like cotton, even though it is wool. But it's warm, as you would expect from wool. So I very much enjoy wearing this item. Okay, right on to the next one. So this item is Adichie by Lisa Richardson, and it's from the Rowan magazine 66. And it is knitted in Rowan alpaca soft, which is a double knit. It's a lovely soft, lovely warm yarn. Because it's very soft, and with the alpaca, it does pill a little bit, so it does require a little bit of maintenance, but it feels really nice to wear. This is not a garment that I wear as often as some of my garments, but it does get worn. I'm wondering for myself why that reason is. I think it's probably because of finding things for it to go with, probably. But it was a really nice item to knit. It's got quite a bit of cabling going on down the sleeve, down the front, and then on the back it's got, I've added in some extra cable. It's got broken rib, and I've added in some extra cable just to make it a little bit more interesting. So, this is a really nice pattern. I've often thought about knitting it again in other colours and other double knit yarns. So this next cardigan is Angelou by Martin Story, and it's available as download on Ravelry. It is a Rowan pattern as well. My version is knitted in Mordel, which is another of the British breeds Rowan yarns. I think it's knitted in a cotton. It probably summer like cotton, but it's a double knit. I've knitted it in a different yarn to the one that the pattern is originally in. Other alterations that I've made, you can see that I've gone for a balloon sleeve. So what I've done here is, rather than increasing the stitches in the sleeve as you go up, as you traditionally would, I've actually increased all those extra stitches just beyond the cuff, and that gives that sort of balloony effect, which I quite like. So I'm looking to try and give a sort of lift to this whole area here to balance me out. So this is quickly, some of you may have seen this. This is something that I have talked about in one of my earlier podcasts, but it's quickly become a real favourite of mine. It's really warm. It's been really nice to throw over the top of a dress over the autumn when I've been going out somewhere, and just having it there in the car if I need it. I thought I'd show you this, as it is one of my favourites and getting worn a lot. It's cropped, which is in the pattern. I haven't got buttons on my version because I'm wearing it as a sort of bolero type cardigan. It's cropped. You can see that. The ribbing, what we are, 2x2 ribbing round on the cuff. I like this pattern. It's pretty straightforward. It's got a slip stitch pattern. So you're doing 4-row stocking stitch and then 2 rows slip stitch, with the slip stitches alternating each other on each row. On to the next one. So this is Mercer by Kim Hargreaves, and this is very much one of my favourite cardigans to wear. It's something I like to throw over the top of a dress. Generally, it's got a bit of a haze to it, it generally tends to be something that I might wear in the evening, going to a restaurant or something like that. So it's Kim Mercer works in conjunction with Rowan. So she's an independent designer. Her books are not Rowan books, but she uses Rowan yarns, and therefore works with the Rowan team when she's producing her designs. And she has actually recently retired after a very long career in knitwear design, but you will find her beautiful designs out there, and they're well worth a look. She does a lovely sort of structured, tailored sort of look, which is very flattering. So it is a bolero style cardigan. It has got a rib down at the bottom. At the back, balloon sleeves. Hers does have buttons, but mine hasn't got buttons, just because I don't do it up. I felt it was going to add a bit of fussing to it, but that is personal taste. It's knitted in Rowan Kid Silk Haze and Rowan Kid Classic, one strand of each held together. I think it's 4.5 or 5 mil needles it was knitted on, so quite fast to knit up. It's gives a nice bit of warmth, like the other cardigans do, so great one to throw over a dress. So these first four cardigans are all dress cardigans that I would wear over a dress, because they're quite short and cropped. And then the next selection that I'm going to show you are things that I would wear over jeans and a blouse or a t-shirt, that kind of thing. So, let's see what we've got in the wardrobe. Right, so this is called the lace cardigan. It is from the Rowan Four Project Haze book. So it's one of those little books that's just got four projects in it. And I think it's available on Ravelry as well. It's knitted in Rowan Kid Classic and Kid Silk Haze held together. So just like the previous blue Mercer cardigan was that I had on. So as I said, these ones are all more that I would wear with jeans because they're longer lined. So I will stand up and show you how this looks with me standing up, because you've seen the longer line is more important. So it has a six row lace pattern repeat, and it's one of those lace patterns that changes the amount of stitches as you go. So it's only on certain rows that you can count and check your stitches. And so I think initially that took a little bit of getting used to that pattern. But once you did, then it was quite straightforward. It's just see the pattern there. And that was on the back as well. So it was one of those patterns that took a little while to get hold of, to get into my head. But once it did, then off it went, and it went quite quickly. And that, of course, because it's on thicker needles. I don't actually wear this that often. I don't know why. I like red. I think it's more to do with the shape of the cardigan. It's quite loose on me, and I'm not sure, being quite short, I don't think I feel so good in a looser long line cardigan. That's probably why I don't wear it so often. Okay, right, on to the next one. So this lovely cardigan is Madura by Georgia Farrell. It's from the Rowan Island Blend Fine book. This is definitely one of my favorites. I love wearing this. I love the color. I love how soft it feels. Because it is a soft yarn, a bit like the alpaca soft, it can pill a little bit, but equally it gets worn an awful lot. So I guess when I think about it, it's not pilled that much considering how much it gets worn. This is one of my favorites. So let's tell you a little bit about it. It is a very straightforward knit. You've just got some rows where you are simply just changing over to a knit one, purl one, then you do some more stocking stitch, then a knit one, purl one row, and then some more stocking stitch. So, you know, really not difficult at all. A really easy knit to do. It's got this wonderful, I say wonderful, there's a lot of work, a lot of stitches to be picked up here, and quite a thick rib, but I think you'll probably agree. I think this is what makes the cardigan, is that nice drapey sort of shawl collar on it. And I'll stand up and show you how it looks as you looking at the front, and it drapes down. It drapes down slightly more at the front than it does at the back. The back's a little bit shorter. Yeah, it just is one. It just feels like something you can wrap yourself up in, throw over a pair of jeans and a blouse and sort of feel a bit dressed, you know. So, okay, on to the next one. So this is Cringle by Martin Story. And this is from Mordell, the Mordell 2 book. And so it is knitted in Mordell. I have changed the colourway from the blue colourway that's in the book. Although if my memory serves me rightly, I think there might be two colourways in the book actually. But yeah, I just played around. As I say, I was still in the store at this time and played around with the different yarns, putting them all together until I got a colourway that I really liked. So it starts off with a burgundy and yellow and then moves on to a red and yellow. And then up the top, it's an orange and yellow. And I really loved the way that faded. And then you've got the burgundy and yellow doing the ribbing on there. And then a similar fading on the sleeves. It's all in garter stitch, which means it's very straightforward. But of course, it takes longer to knit. And you notice it when you're doing such a big item, just because the garter stitch, the stitches are shorter, so they take longer to knit up your length, and you do notice that in a longer piece like this. It's lovely. The Mordell, again, as I say, it's that pure British wool. It's lovely and warm. I wouldn't wear the Mordell personally right next to my skin, so I've got a blouse on underneath here in it, but then it's that kind of garment you would probably want to be doing that anyway, so don't wear it as much. I really enjoyed knitting it, just because of the colour changes and the stripes. It kept it interesting while still being really simple. But I don't wear it that often. And I think that's probably because, it's a long line cardigan. And I don't feel so confident in a long line cardigan. I feel a bit swamped in it. But it is great when we do the canal boats. This is a good one to throw on over the top. When we first arrive on the canal boats, sometimes in the winter they can be a little bit chillier, but until we get inside the boat and warm up. So this is a great one to throw on and do that. Okay, right, on to the next one. Okay, so this is the coral pattern it's a quail pattern from Rowan Essential Bright. And in the you may have heard me talking about this before, because I did this in a blue over the summer, and that was just in hand knit cotton, which is a thick sort of cotton. In the actual pattern, it is knitted in Summerlight DK, which is a DK cotton, and a strand of Kid Silk Haze. But I've actually knitted mine in Rowan felted tweed and Kid Silk Haze, and I'll give you a sort of close-up shot so you can see the what the fabric looks like of it, because it's rather lovely. Felted tweed is gorgeous anyway, and then putting in the avocado coloured Kid Silk Haze really gives it a special look. So this is a garment that I love to knit. I love to wear. I love to knit it too. It's definitely one of my favorites. I think the only thing, I'm still getting used to wearing slipovers. you know, it's a great style, great, easy to put together, and sort of looks well, or looks good, should I say. But I don't always tend, I often tend to just go for a jumper when I've got a pair of jeans on. So it's, in case you're not familiar with the pattern, it's a straightforward stocking stitch, plain on the back. So you're knitting the back and the front, you're sewing your shoulder seams, and you're picking up your stitches around the neck and doing your V-neck with your decreasing to create your V, and then picking up the stitches around the for the armbands. The bottom is got a the back is deeper than the front, and so that creates quite a nice look. Obviously, you could always change it if you wanted to, but I quite like that look on it. So that's the 8 knits that I have to show you from my wardrobe. I'm now knitting more different designs and going away from the row, and just really because it's really interesting, because it challenges me a bit more into different areas, different types of knitting that I haven't done before. So I'm really enjoying that challenge, and that's what we've been sharing on the podcast. So there is one, finally, before we go though, I have got one knit that is very much in my mind that I haven't got with me, because we are down in Cornwall at the moment, and yeah, it doesn't live. I have a deep drawer that I keep all my knits in, and it doesn't live in that drawer. It lives downstairs in my understairs cloakroom, and it is a poncho called Cloudberry, knitted in Mordell, and I'm putting some photos up for you. Knitted in Mordell. It's from the Mordell Book 1. So quite a few of the items you saw here were knitted in Mordell. So that's that lovely wool, British wool. It's slightly itchy, so you wouldn't want to wear it next to your skin, but again, works brilliantly for a poncho. So this poncho is fantastic for throwing over the top of things. And it's just a rectangle. You start off doing a bit of lace, and then you're just doing plain stocking stitch, rectangle, and then a bit of lace at the end. Then you fold it, you seam the piece over the shoulder, and then pick up the stitches for the piece around the neck. And then good, so you can see the good big bit of ribbing for the neck. So that's a really lovely piece to be able to throw on and keep you warm, you know, when you're going from one place to another. Brilliant to wear in the car when you're driving somewhere. So I thought I'd share that bit with you as well, because it's a really nice piece, and again, worn an awful lot. So that's that all done. I hope to do something similar maybe in the spring, looking back at my summer knits. These were all my sort of winter knits. Doesn't seem much point in talking about summer stuff right now, as we're right in the middle of autumn. But hopefully in the spring we'll get out and we'll look at the summer knits and have a chat about those, and what works and what doesn't work, and what I'm wearing and so forth. So, okay, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please do like and subscribe. That would be so helpful to help build my channel, and I would really appreciate that. So until the next time, which won't hopefully be too long, take care. And happy knitting.